Baseball Weekly Update here with head coach Rob Bishop. Let's recap a series sweep against Fort Wayne. Actually ended up being a season sweep of them, 6-0 against the Mastodons Friday afternoon. Good win there. Field conditions maybe a little sloppy, but Tyler Olmstead pitched a four-hit shutout and earned your team an 8-0 win.
Yeah, Tyler was really good. You know, he's been very consistent, especially in the back half of this season, and he was especially efficient this weekend. I think he threw 102 pitches in the game and had a lot of early contact. Our defense played well, and you know, we did enough in spurts offensively to kind of play from ahead, which is you know, makes the game definitely a lot easier and makes it easier to pitch where you can just be aggressive in the zone and not be too worried about, you know, giving up that one big swing that costs you. So good team win on Friday.
Saturday, a 7-4 win. That game a little tighter earlier in that game, though. Purdue Fort Wayne tied it up at 4. Give you guys credit for rallying back. Logan Holtz, obviously the big two-run homer to give yourself some separation and a win there as well.
Yeah, Landon Badger had a two-run home run, and Holtz had a big home run late, and those two swings ended up being the difference for us. Ryan Fromm was pretty good. The walk bit him a little bit. I think he walked 5 guys. A couple of those guys scored, one on a home run and another one. I think we had an error and a walk together that cost us a little bit. Phelps did a good job for them in relief. They were a little different with their pitching. They used a kind of a short relief guy to start it, and then Phelps threw 5 innings in the middle. And with the exception of Badger's home run, he did a really good job and kept them in the game. I think it was 4-4 in the 7th, so tight game to the end. Our offense put together some good at-bats late, and Brett Barnett was really good at the end of that game. I think he got 7 outs, and boy, when I went back and watched the video, he didn't throw a lot of hittable pitches. He was velocity was good, breaking ball was good, so Brett's been outstanding, so it was good to get him out there and have a good outing and get another win.
12-2 win on Sunday in 7 innings. Nick McKay gave up a few runs early, but really clamped down in that 3rd inning on. I don't think he gave up a hit the rest of the game, and short game there, ending it in 7 innings.
Yeah, they came out swinging the bat pretty well in the first inning. I think they had 3 first inning hits against Nick. He left a few pitches up. We had one mistake, I think a bad pickoff attempt. That you know, could have cost us a run there. They get one there. They bunted a little bit in the 2nd inning, tried some small ball. Nick has been really good all year, so I'm sure they were just kind of looking for some holes in the armor a little bit. And then he settled in after the 2nd. He was upset with himself in the first 2 innings with just maybe his command and how he was pitching. And one thing Nick's done a great job of all year, and an exceptional job for a freshman, is just being really focused pitch to pitch. And he got kind of locked back in that 3rd inning. It was really, really good the rest of the way. And offensively, we did a really good job against their starter, kind of got him out of the game early and got their bullpen, you know, out of position a little bit early, I'd say. And just were able to score some runs. So it was a beautiful day Saturday and Sunday at the park, and a great series win for us.
A nice weekend for Josh Falk, 7 RBIs on 5 hits, and then also a good weekend for Landon Badger to get back going after a rough weekend down in Omaha.
Yeah, Badger was solid again. You know, he's always very good defensively, but when his bat's hot, you know, he's one of those guys when you look at the extra base hits on our team, you don't necessarily think of him as the guy, but I think he's got 14 or 15 extra base hits on the season, which just has to rank him in the top 3 or 4 guys on our team, and way up there in the Summit League as well. We just kind of leave him down there in the 9 hole and try to not mess with him, let him do his thing, and understand he's going to play great defense. And when he's good offensively, he really can spark us. Obviously has some speed, he can use the bunt. So he sets the top of our lineup up pretty well. I thought Derek Hackman had really good at-bats this weekend. On-base percentage was way up there. Drew Beasley kind of quietly had a really good weekend as well. So we had a bunch of guys offensively that just did a good job. We took our walks, and that's something that we've been working on and preaching in practice. And we took advantage of those free bases this weekend.
You've got a midweek game tomorrow at Minnesota, a team you played a few weeks ago. But when you look at this game tomorrow, it's actually, you know, really good to have that game, especially with as few arms as pitched this last weekend against Purdue Fort Wayne.
Yeah, it's a problem and a good problem to have. We only had four guys throw in the three-game series. You know, most times you'd be really excited about that, but honestly, this time of year, we need to get those guys back out there, get those relief guys back out there. So we'll likely use five or six different guys tomorrow. Obviously, against a really good Minnesota team, they've been playing really well in Big Ten play, and in the back half of the year, they've been hot. So it'd be a great challenge for us, and really just a better than any practice that we could have, just a really good tune-up for Oral Roberts coming in here this weekend. And they didn't have a great weekend last weekend, so you know they'll come in ready to go, and they have a lot to play for, and we have a lot to play for, so it should be a fun weekend. We have alumni weekend. We'll honor our seniors this weekend, so a lot going on, and our last home series of the year.